What if I told you Honda engineered a two-stroke dirt bike in the 1990s that could rival its larger competitors, achieve lower emissions, and outpace four strokes at rallies? Welcome back to Motorcycle Library. The Honda EXP-2 was built to challenge perceptions of what a two-stroke could do at a time when emissions regulations were tightening and four-stroke engines were gaining ground in the market. Yet, despite its technical achievements, Honda walked away from the project after just 1 year. We'll uncover why Honda's game-changing two-stroke went from podium contender to museum piece in months. The story of the EXP-2 begins with a question. How did a two-stroke bike with an experimental engine surpass expectations in one of the most challenging forms of motorsport? The experimental bike that took rally racing by storm, the Honda EXP-2, quickly established itself as a standout in the world of rally racing. Developed in the mid-1990s, the EXP-2 was Honda's answer to growing concerns over the future of two-stroke engines. Emissions regulations were tightening across major markets, including California and Europe, threatening to sideline the lightweight, high-revving engines that had long dominated off-road competition. Two-strokes were valued for their simplicity, power, and weight advantages, but they faced criticism for inefficiency and high emissions. Honda's engineers set out to challenge this perception, determined to demonstrate that two-strokes could evolve. At its core, the EXP-2 was a purpose-built machine designed for the rigors of desert rallying. It featured a 402 cubic centimeter two-stroke engine, drawing on proven components from the CR500 motocross bike, and housed Honda's new activated radical combustion ARC system, which we'll explain shortly. The frame was a combination of hand-built aluminum tubes and sheet metal, engineered for both strength and reduced weight. This construction resulted in a machine that was approximately 50 kilograms lighter than many of its four-stroke rivals, a significant edge in long-distance competition, where every kilogram counted. The 1995 Paris-Granada rally, so named that year, due to political changes affecting the traditional Paris-Dakar route, served as the EXP-2's proving ground. The event covered over 8,000 kilometers of harsh terrain, ranging from sand dunes to rocky outcrops and searing desert temperatures. In this demanding environment, the EXP-2 exceeded expectations. It won the under 500cc class and finished fifth overall, outperforming many larger displacement bikes that were expected to dominate. The lighter chassis and responsive engine allowed the EXP-2 to excel in technical sections, where agility and traction were essential. The bike's handling and power-to-weight ratio enabled it to maintain momentum through loose sand and rough ground, areas where heavier competitors often struggled. Reliability was a critical factor in the EXP-2's success. The Paris-Granada rally routinely exposed weaknesses in even the most established machines. The EXP-2, however, proved its durability, handling both desert heat and rocky terrain without major mechanical issues. Honda's focus on robust engineering and thorough real-world testing meant the bike could withstand the stresses of multi-day racing, minimizing the risk of breakdowns that had plagued earlier two-stroke attempts in similar events. The use of lightweight materials also reduced wear on moving parts, contributing to the bike's consistent performance across stages. Following its strong debut, the EXP-2 continued to demonstrate its capabilities in other high-profile events. In the Baja 1000, the bike secured a win in its class and finished seventh overall, confirming its competitiveness in North America's most demanding off-road race. The Nevada rally provided another test of endurance and adaptability, where the EXP-2 again won its class and placed eighth overall. These results highlighted not only the bike's speed and handling, but also its versatility across varying conditions, from desert expanses to technical rocky courses. Central to the EXP-2's performance was its integration of advanced technology. The engine's ARC system represented a significant step forward for two-stroke design. While the specifics of ARC will be discussed in detail in the next section, it is worth noting that this system allowed the EXP-2 to address the emissions and efficiency concerns that had long limited the future of two-stroke motorcycles. The bike also featured a computer-controlled exhaust valve and electronic fuel injection, supporting both power delivery and emissions management. Riders reported that the EXP-2 produced an unusual sound, described as similar to a small turbo diesel, reflecting the unique combustion process at work. Honda's approach with the EXP-2 was not simply to win races, but to prove a concept. The bike's success in multiple rally events challenged industry assumptions about the limitations of two-stroke engines, especially in an era when regulatory pressures were mounting. By integrating innovative technology with practical engineering, Honda demonstrated that two-stroke motorcycles could remain competitive and environmentally viable. The achievements of the EXP-2 extended beyond the trophies it collected. Its design and performance raised questions about what was possible for the future of motorcycle technology. With the ARC system at its core, the EXP-2 suggested that two-stroke engines might not be obsolete after all. This innovation set the stage for a closer look at how Honda aimed to revolutionize two-stroke technology and address the challenges posed by increasingly strict emission standards. How Honda revolutionized two-stroke technology. Honda's ARC system rethought two-stroke combustion at a molecular level, aiming to match four-stroke emissions without sacrificing power. As environmental regulations tightened throughout the 1990s, especially in the United States and Europe, two-stroke engines faced mounting scrutiny for their high emissions and inefficiency. Honda's approach with activated radical combustion was not a minor adjustment, but a comprehensive redesign intended to resolve the fundamental shortcomings of conventional two-strokes. The primary challenge for traditional two-stroke engines was incomplete combustion, particularly at low RPMs. This issue resulted in unburned fuel escaping through the exhaust port, leading to high hydrocarbon emissions and wasted fuel. The ARC system addressed this by precisely controlling combustion inside the cylinder. At the heart of the system was a specially designed exhaust valve that regulated pressure in the combustion chamber, supported by electronic fuel injection and a suite of sensors. This setup enabled near-total combustion of the fuel-air mixture, even at low engine speeds. A key feature of ARC was its ability to manage ignition in a highly controlled manner. The system used the pressure valve to influence the timing and location of combustion, igniting the charge from countless points within the chamber. This process resulted in faster, more uniform combustion, and reduced the likelihood of unburned hydrocarbons passing into the exhaust. To ensure reliability, a spark plug was retained as a backup, automatically taking over at idle or under heavy engine load when ARC's self-ignition was less effective. This dual approach gave the EXP-2 a level of adaptability and consistency not seen in earlier two-stroke designs. The environmental impact of ARC was significant. Honda reported that hydrocarbons were reduced by 80%, nitrous oxides by 90%, and carbon monoxide and dioxide by 15% compared to conventional two-strokes. These reductions demonstrated that the EXP-2 could meet or exceed the emissions standards that were beginning to reshape the motorcycle industry. Improved combustion also meant better fuel efficiency, which was especially valuable for rally racing, where long stages and limited refueling opportunities demanded maximum range. Performance gains were equally important. The more thorough combustion process delivered a smoother, more predictable power curve, addressing the erratic throttle response often associated with two-stroke engines. Riders experienced improved control and responsiveness, particularly in technical rally sections where traction and precise throttle modulation were critical. Combined with the EXP-2's lightweight chassis, the ARC system allowed the bike to compete directly with four-stroke rivals, often surpassing them in acceleration and handling. Implementing this technology, however, involved substantial engineering challenges. The EXP-2 required advanced computing, electronic controls, and extensive sensor arrays, features rarely seen on dirt bikes of the era. Each prototype cost a staggering $250,000 to $500,000, reflecting the complexity of the design and the intensive development process. Much of this expense was tied to the precision machining, custom electronics, and rigorous real-world testing needed to refine ARC and ensure its reliability under the demands of rally racing. Honda indicated that much of the electronics were intended to streamline testing and data collection rather than to complicate the final product, but the high costs remained a significant barrier to mass production. The science behind ARC drew on decades of combustion research. Honda's engineers built upon foundational studies from the mid-20th century, adapting theoretical advances in controlled combustion to the practical requirements of a high-performance motorcycle engine. By leveraging computer modeling and hands-on experimentation, they succeeded in translating complex principles into a working system that could be deployed in competition. Despite its promise, ARC had operational constraints. The system engaged from about 5% to 60% throttle, with its optimal effectiveness between 6% and 22% engine load. Outside these parameters, the spark plug assumed a greater role, which meant the full benefits of ARC were not always available throughout the engine's operating range. This fallback ensured consistent performance, but it also highlighted the limitations of the technology for broader, everyday use. The combination of a narrow optimal range and high development costs posed challenges for adapting ARC to mass-market motorcycles. Nevertheless, the ARC-equipped EXP-2 demonstrated that two-stroke engines could be engineered to meet modern emissions standards while delivering competitive performance. Honda's work showed that the perceived divide between environmental responsibility and high-output engine design was not insurmountable. The EXP-2's technical success raised important questions about the future of two-stroke motorcycles, and suggested that innovation could keep the platform relevant even as industry trends shifted. Yet, the story of the EXP-2 is defined not only by its achievements, but also by what happened next. The factors that shaped the fate of this experimental machine extended beyond engineering, touching on market dynamics, regulatory pressures, and economic realities. Why Honda abandoned the EXP-2 after its first year? Honda's decision to discontinue the EXP-2 after only 1 year stemmed from a combination of shifting industry trends, regulatory changes, and economic realities that quickly overtook the promise of its technology. The EXP-2 was conceived as a showcase for two-stroke innovation, demonstrating that emissions and efficiency could be improved without sacrificing performance. Its results in the 1995 Paris-Granada rally, including a class win and a fifth-place overall finish, provided concrete proof of its engineering merit. However, these achievements could not insulate the project from the broader forces reshaping the motorcycle landscape in the late 1990s. The growing popularity of four-stroke dirt bikes played a decisive role in the EXP-2's fate. Four-stroke engines, once considered less competitive due to weight and complexity, gained traction as manufacturers introduced liquid cooling, multi-valve heads, and improved reliability. Their broader power band and better fuel economy appealed to recreational riders, while their reputation for cleaner operation aligned with public sentiment and regulatory trends. The release of Yamaha's YZ400F in 1998 marked a watershed moment. It proved that four-stroke rivals could match two-stroke performance, tipping the market and influencing consumer expectations across the industry. As a result, Honda faced a shrinking audience for advanced two-stroke platforms, even one as innovative as the EXP-2. Emissions regulations further tightened the noose around two-stroke development. By the mid-1990s, California had outlawed off-road two-stroke motorcycles, setting a precedent that other jurisdictions were poised to follow. The ARC system on the EXP-2 made significant progress in reducing emissions, but the regulatory environment evolved faster than Honda anticipated. When emission limits tightened beyond initial forecasts, the ARC bike no longer met the stamp of clean in key markets. Hydrocarbon and nitrous oxide reductions, though impressive, were not enough to overcome the stigma and legal barriers attached to two strokes. The market increasingly favored four strokes, which could achieve compliance with less technological risk and greater certainty. Economic considerations also weighed heavily on the project's prospects. The cost of developing and producing the EXP-2 was extraordinarily high. Early prototypes reportedly cost between $250,000 and $500,000 each, reflecting the complexity of the ARC system, advanced electronics, and precision manufacturing required. Honda claimed some prototype electronics were test instrumentation, but costs even excluding those systems remained prohibitive for mass production. The combination of specialized components, computer-controlled exhaust valves, and electronic fuel injection meant that bringing the EXP-2 to market would have required a retail price far above what most riders were willing to pay. This financial reality made it difficult to justify continued investment, particularly as four-stroke technology advanced and captured a growing share of the market. Timing further disadvantaged the EXP-2. By the late 1990s, Honda and other manufacturers were redirecting resources toward four-stroke development, driven by both consumer demand and regulatory support. Off-road and motocross enthusiasts embraced four-strokes as their performance closed the gap with two-strokes and, in some cases, surpassed it. regulatory agencies favored four strokes as inherently cleaner, making them a safer long-term bet. Honda's leadership faced a choice. Continue investing in a two-stroke platform with limited commercial prospects, or focus on refining four-stroke models that aligned with evolving market and regulatory requirements. The decision to shift priorities was pragmatic, reflecting the need to adapt to external pressures rather than a lack of faith in the EXP-2's engineering. Despite the project's cancellation, some of the EXP-2's innovations found a second life. Honda redirected lessons from ARC and lightweight chassis engineering into other initiatives, most notably the Baja program, where spin-off tech from EXP-2 powered successes for years after. The knowledge gained from the project informed Honda's broader approach to off-road racing and contributed to incremental improvements across its product lineup. In this sense, the EXP-2 served as both a technological testbed and a bridge to future developments, even if its own production run was cut short. The discontinuation of the EXP-2 was not the result of a single failing, but rather the outcome of a convergence of market trends, regulatory shifts, and economic constraints. The motorcycle industry was undergoing a period of rapid transformation, and even a technically successful, innovative project could not escape the realities of cost, compliance, and consumer demand. The EXP-2's story illustrates how external forces can define the trajectory of even the most advanced engineering efforts. As the dust settled, the legacy of the EXP-2 lay in its demonstration of what was possible when innovation pushed against the boundaries of convention. Its brief existence raised questions about the potential of two-stroke technology in a changing world, and its influence lingered in Honda's approach to future challenges. The Honda EXP-2 stands as evidence that two-stroke engines could be engineered to meet modern environmental standards while delivering competitive performance. Innovations such as the activated radical combustion system showed that high performance and lower emissions were possible in a single package. The EXP-2 proved two strokes could be clean and competitive, yet timing and economics cut its life short. Its spirit lives on in today's rally bikes, where lessons from the project continue to influence Honda's off-road engineering. Leave a comment below. Do you think ARC could find new life with today's tech? If you enjoyed this deep dive, like the video, subscribe for more motorcycle history, and tap the bell to never miss an episode.